you realize that people there this afternoon were expressing their deep concern from their home communities, from the grassroots, for the enactment of civil rights legislation, yes, but for a change in the climate that will affect their daily lives. We who come to you occasionally and to the Congress intermittently and say what our people want, and when I say our people, I stress the interracial character of this because I mean all the people who believe in justice and who feel that the government should function to bring about justice. Those of us who come to you and say our people want this and we want that, we think so and so ought to be done, understandably, you might feel at times that this is a program dreamed up by the leaders, or at least pushed by them for some motive of their own with hopes that they have backing. We think today's demonstration, if it did nothing else, and I think this was the principal thing it did, showed that the people back home, from the small towns, the big cities, the working people, men who gave up 2 days' pay, 3 days' pay, who paid $30, $40, $50, and $100, who flew from Los Angeles, a $300 round trip to come here. It means that they, and not Martin Luther King or Roy Wilkins or Whitney Young or Walter Luther, have dreamed up this civil rights business. They feel it in their hearts enough to come here and show by their presence to you and to the Congress what they hope their government